What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my laboratory, where safety is number one priority. And today I'm going to show you pretty amazing experiment with a light bulb. How to make a plasma ball from a regular light bulb. Well, let's find out. So I got here wooden coil or Tesla coil. It's a high voltage coil, goes up to between 20,000 to 50,000 volt. There is a little attachment that goes into it. So we're going to plug it in and I'll show you what it does. And look at this. Now I'm gonna touch it. Pretty insane, right? Look at this. This is like lightning bulbs. So this little handheld Tesla coil is amazing for a lot of experiments. It is used for industrial purposes, also very dangerous. So I wouldn't let kids play with that. Look how beautiful it is. You gotta see the close-up for it. Also, I don't want to use it for 10 minutes or longer, because it will burn out, or who knows what it will do. Going to shut off the lights even more, and let's see what we can do with this thing. Look at it, there's electricity flying out, and then... This thing actually keeps shutting off my camera, so I gotta move it a little bit farther away. Okay, let's turn off all the lights and try this again. Alright, as you can see, there's electricity coming off a little blue spark. And now we're gonna move it closer to metal. I hope it doesn't break my camera, because it keeps shutting off my camera. But this is between 20,000 volts to 50,000 volts. Pretty incredible. It keeps messing with my camera, so I don't want to destroy it. Very expensive camera. So I'm gonna move it a little bit farther away. So I unplugged it. You see it's not shocking me anymore. So I'm gonna unplug this part out. And I got here a little attachment. And I'm gonna get this old school light bulb. And we're going to make a plasma inside of a light bulb. We're gonna screw it in, just like that, and put it inside. Boom. All ready to go. I'm going to get different lenses so I can film a little bit farther away so it doesn't shut off my camera anymore. So this time I should be able to touch this light bulb. Let's try it out. Ow! That hurt! That's actually shocked me quite a bit. Maybe I got the wrong kind of light bulb. Look at this. This is so beautiful. You should be able to touch it, but this light bulb might be a little bit too small for that. But look how beautiful this is. Wow. Let's grab a piece of metal out here. Wow, it's going to a light bulb. I think this globe is just not big enough. This is right here at 40,000 volts. I'm gonna turn down some voltage. Let's see if it's gonna shock me. Woo! It doesn't shock me. It kinda, ouch! It kinda shocking me a little bit. It's kinda weird tingly feeling. I'm gonna take it down a lot more. Here you go. Now I can hold it. Less voltage. So now I can actually touch it. Awesome. Look how beautiful it is. Kinda hurts a little bit after a while, like pinching it. Wow, look how beautiful this is. It's a bit tingly, but I like it. This is so cool. Ow. If I take it down a little bit of voltage, here you go, it doesn't hurt. So that should be about at 20,000 volts. At 50,000 volts, it pinches a lot more. So this is like almost doesn't feel anything. But look how beautiful this is. I love it. And right here, it should be at 50,000 volts. Alright, 50,000 volts. Look how beautiful it is. And then we're gonna put a piece of metal out here. Is it conducting soon? Wow, look at this. To the light bulb. So cool, look at this. And then I'm just gonna fill it up with liquid nitrogen.